हेलो चिल्ड्रन, वेलकम बैक टू आवर चैप्टर 9 हाफ्स एंड क्वार्टर्स। इन लास्ट वीडियो वी हैव कंप्लीटेड अप टू पेज 104। टुडे वी विल स्टार्ट फ्रॉम 105। इन दिस पेज वी हैव गिवन द टॉपिक बैलेंस द वेट। हियर वी हैव गिवन ऑफ डिफरेंट वेट्स, वेट्स ऑफ 1 kg, 500 ग्राम, 250 ग्राम, 200 ग्राम, 100 ग्राम and 50 grams, and just below that we have given a balance, and in one pan of the balance given 2 kg, and we have to equalize the next pan with of different weights, equalizing of 2 kg. Here let me read the question. Choose from the weights above to make the two pans equal. In how many ways can you do it? That means here in one pan it is kept 2 kg weight. The next pan we have to equalize, that means should be 2 kg by choosing different weights of the above pictures. Here students, we can do in many ways. As we have know that 1 kilogram is 1000 gram. So 2 kilogram means how many grams? 2000 grams. So how can we combine these weights to make 2000 grams? I will show in another page, as there is no space in this page. See students, these are the different ways to equalize both the pans of the balance, both the pans to balance. That means in one pan there is 2000 gram. So one, the first one we can select 1 kilogram plus 500 gram plus 500 gram, total 2000 gram. So if we keep 1 kilogram and 2 weights of 500 grams, we can equalize the next pan with the 2000 gram. This is the first method or one method. And next one is 1 kilogram plus 500 gram plus 250 gram plus 250 gram, total 2000 gram. In this way also, because here we have given weights of these grams, that is here we have given 500 gram of weight, 250 gram, 200 gram, 50 gram and 100 gram. So the second one I selected this way, 1 kilogram plus 500 gram plus 250 plus 250. So total we will get 2000 gram. In this is the another way of balancing both the pans. Now the third one, the combination of third is combination of weights to equalize 2000 gram of the first pan is 1 kilogram plus 500 gram plus 250 gram plus 200 gram plus 50 gram. So total you, if you add 1 kilogram means 1000 gram, 1000 gram plus 500 gram, 1500 gram plus 250 equals 1750 plus 2 equals 200 gram equals 1950 plus 50 equals 2000 gram. This is the third way of equalizing both the balance. Now the another way, fourth way, this is first 1 kilogram plus 500 gram plus 200 gram plus 200 gram plus 100 gram. All these weights if you add, we will add together, we will get 2000 gram. This is the fourth way of combining all the weights to make 2000 gram. Now that another way is 1 kilogram plus 250 gram plus 250 gram plus 250 gram plus 200 gram plus 50 gram. If we add all these weights, we will get 2000 gram. So these are the different ways to combine different grams to equalize both the pans to get 2000 gram or 2 kilogram. Now the second question is, draw the weight in the empty pan. Draw the weights. So I have already showed 5 combination of different weights to make 2000 gram or 2 kilogram. Any one of the combination you select, or otherwise you select your own combination and draw weights in the another pan of this balancer. That you have to do yourself. Now the question B in this page. Question B is, in how many ways can you balance this weight of 3/4 kg. To balance 3/4 kg of this 1000 gram or 1 kg, how many ways can you balance this weight? Now let's see. We know that there are 1000 grams in 1 kilogram. So first we have to find out 1/4 of this kilogram. What is 1/4 of this kilogram? 1/4 is, to find the 1/4 of 1 kilogram, we have to multiply 1/4 by 1000. Multiply by 1000. 1000 multiplied by 1/4 is 250 gram. Now we have to find the 3 quarters. So 3 times the take the quarters. Quarter of 1000 gram is 250 gram. So 3 times taking means 250 plus 250 plus 250. So we will get 750 gram. 250 plus 250 plus 250 gram is 750 gram. So that is the 3 quarters of 1 kilogram. So how can we balance that? In another pan, to balance, we can keep 3 250 grams. This is the one way. Another way is to find the 3/4 of 1 kilogram is multiply by 3/4 by 1000. 3/4 multiply by 1000 is 750 gram. The another method to balance the next pan is 500 gram plus 200 gram plus 50 gram. So total 750 gram. If we keep in this way also, the weights of 500, 200 plus 50, we can balance the next pan. And another way is, we are available of 250 gram weight, 250 gram weight, 200 gram and 50 gram. So if we select or combine these weights, we can balance the next pan. These are the 3 different ways of balancing the weight of 3 quarters of 1 kilogram or 1000 gram. Now let's move to next page of this chapter. Page is 106. See the topic. Why is it wrong? Here we have given 2 pictures. One is a rectangle and another one is a triangle. And the rectangle is divided and colored some of its parts. And the triangle also colored some of its part. Here, the question is, Kannan shaded some parts as shown. But his friend Mini says that it is wrong. Explain why it is wrong. Students, we have to find out how many parts the rectangle is divided equally and the triangle divided. And his friend said it is wrong. We have to find out why it is wrong. Why she said it is wrong. See, first of all, we have to observe this rectangle and find out how many equal parts are there in that rectangle. How many equal parts are there? Actually, that rectangle is divided into 5 equal parts. But Kannan written that the shaded part is 1/4 part. Now we know that it is wrong because out of 5 equal parts, 2 parts are colored red. But Kannan written it is 1/4 part. Actually, the shaded part is 2/5 part. Out of 5 equal parts, 2 parts are shaded or colored. But Kannan has written it is 1/4 part. So we know that this shaded part he represented is wrong. Actually, he has to write 2/5. 2/5 is shaded part. Now the second picture is a triangle. Students, see that triangle. It is not shown how much part of this triangle is shaded. The exact how much part of this triangle is not shaded. Because this triangle is not able to divide or it cannot be divided equally in any way. So, the shaded part is not showing equal parts. So, it cannot be say the exact part of this triangle. How much part of this triangle is shaded or colored, we cannot say. Now, let's move to the last topic of this chapter, practice time. In this
topic, we have given four different questions. We have to find the answers for these questions. There are 60 mangoes. 1/2 or half of them are ripe. How many mangoes are ripe? So we have to find the half of 60. So here I have given the question with the solution. First we have to find the half of 60. Total how many mangoes are there? There are 60 mangoes are there. To find the half of the 60 mangoes, multiply half by 60. So half of 60 is 60 divided by 2 is 30. So how many mangoes, ripe mangoes? There are 30 ripe mangoes are there. Now question 2 is, there are 32 children. Half of them are girls. How many children are boys? Here also we have to find the half of 32 children. Half of 32 children are girls and the half are boys. To find the half of 32, the same way we have to multiply half by 32. Half multiplied by 32 is 32 divided by 2 is 16. So how many boys are there? There are 16 boys in out of 32 children. Out of 32 children, 16 boys are there. Now question 3. There are 20 stars. A quarter of them are red. How many stars are red? Here we have to find quarter of 20, not half. In last two questions, we found half of the given numbers. Here we have to find the quarter. Quarter means 1/4 of 20. Quarter means 1/4. To find quarter of 20, multiply 1/4 or quarter by 20. This way we can do. So 1/4 multiply by 20 is 20 divided by 4 is 5 stars. So how many red stars are there? 5 red stars are there. Now one more question also given there. How many are not red? Out of 20, we find out how many red stars are there. That means 5 red stars are there. Now we have to find number of not red stars. That means total 20 stars minus number of red stars. That is 5 equals 15 non-red stars. So how many red not red stars are there? 15 not red stars are there. Now the last question is, Ravi wants a pencil. It cost rupees 2. He gives a 1 rupee coin, 1 half rupee coin and 1 quarter rupee coin. Now the question is it enough? The question is, Ravi wants a pencil. Cost of pencil is 2 rupees. He given 1 rupee coin. That means 1 rupee plus 1 half rupee coin. That means 50 paisa plus 1 quarter rupee coin means 25 paisa. Total he gave 1 rupee plus 50 paisa plus 25 paisa means total 1.75 rupees he has given. That means he gave 1 rupees and 75 paisa. But actually what was the cost of pencil? 2 rupees. Is it enough, children? No. The money required more is, to find out we have to subtract 2 rupees minus 1.75. That is rupees 0.25. That means 25 paisa more paisa is required to buy that pencil. That means if Ravi wants to buy that pencil, he required more 25 paisa. That is rupees 0.25 more rupees is required to buy that pencil. Children, now we have completed our textbook. Next video, we will start with our workbook.